we have a tradition that comes from the first millennium BC somewhere else, and we are handling that. It has not turned over and assimilated the qualities of our culture and the new things that are possible and the new vision of the universe. It must be kept alive. The only people that can keep it alive are artists. The artist is, his function is the mythologization of the environment and the world. The experience of people particularly gifted whose ears are open to the song of the universe, and that they speak to the folk, and there is an answer from the folk which is then received. There's an interaction, but the first impulse comes from above, not from below, in the shaping of folk traditions.
So who would have been in these early elementary cultures, as you call them, the equivalent of the poets today?
The shamans. The shaman is a person who has, in his late childhood, early youth, could be male or female, had an overwhelming psychological experience that turns them totally inward. The whole unconscious has opened up and they've fallen into it. It's a kind of schizophrenic crack-up, the shaman experience. Dying and resurrecting. Being on the brink of death and coming back, actually experience the death experience. People who have very deep dreams. Dream is a great source of the spirit. Magnified dreams, and what dreams are manifestations in image form of the energies of the body in conflict with each other. And that's all myth is. Myth is a manifestation in symbolic images, metaphorical images of the energies within us. Heaven and hell are within us, and all the gods are within us. Here's a whole mythology based on the insight that transcends duality. Ours is a mythology that's based on the insight of duality. One has eaten of the tree of the knowledge, not only of good and evil, but of male and female, of right and wrong, of this and that, and light and dark. Everything in the field of time is dual, past and future, dead and alive. All this, being and non-being, is, isn't.
Thank you.
religion is a defense against a religious experience. Well, that means it has reduced the whole thing to concepts and ideas. And having the concept and idea short-circuits the transcendent experience. And the ultimate word in our language for that which is transcendent is God. God is a thought. God is a name. God is an idea. But its reference is to something that transcends all thinking. The ultimate mystery of being is beyond all categories of thought. If one has a mind that's willing to just relax and identify itself with that which moves it.
We don't care who likes it or not, as long as we know it's the truth.
Every mythology, every religion is true in this sense. It is true as metaphorical of the human and cosmic mystery. That which is beyond even the concept of reality, is that which transcends all thought. It's putting you there all the time. And in some way, giving you a line to connect with that mystery which you are. The experience of deep mystery is what one has to regard as the ultimate religious experience.
It's not just questioning and looking for a quick answer or an explanation, but that the process of inquiry, of questioning, opening, is open something in the human being which has not been touched in our culture. So it's really, it's not a question of whether you're in this field or that field. Everybody who is human has in themselves a potential of a passionate inquiry after truth.
The image of God becomes the final obstruction. Your God is your ultimate barrier. God is an intelligible sphere, that's say a sphere known to the mind, whose center is everywhere and circumference nowhere. And the center is right where you're sitting. And each of us is a manifestation of that mystery.
Hunab Ku Productions.